Hello everyone, Michael Lanfield here, coming back at you, and so I'm in my new place, and I love it here. And so today's topic is about moving, and about life, and journey, and our journeys, and all of that. So hopefully I can make this short and sweet. So, when you're on a journey, when you're in this life, and in your body, just follow your heart. Use your intuition when doing anything. Of course, you can take tips and ideas from others, but ultimately, it is using your intuition, going with your heart and your bones, and really understanding where you lie and where you want to go. If you see the future, your future, if you see what you envision, if you envision a world of love and compassion and peace, and you envision your something particular to get you to get you there, your purpose, well, that is where your heart and your mind have to take you. And I think when it came to me, I just followed my heart. I just followed my intuition. I just said, this is what I want to do. I don't care if I, you know, to the point where I, you know, live in the woods with a tent. I'm going to do what I have to in order to fulfill my heart, in order to fulfill what my mission and my purpose is, which is really to raise consciousness and love on this planet and to unconditionally love all beings and to teach that to others. And so that is my mission. That is my purpose. And so I'm alive here today because I think the universe needs me to really to spread this message of love and compassion to the world and to try and get people to understand, or at least not get people to understand, but at least to plant the seeds of kindness, compassion for all beings, and to be an example of that. And so my journey is slow, but progressing, you know, little by little, and it's there. I mean, I've written a book. It's the Interconnectedness of Life. It's available worldwide on Amazon and everywhere around the world. And so if you have a computer and internet, you can purchase it. If you have, you know, decent income, you can definitely purchase the book. Get the book at weareinterconnected.com. And if you can't afford it at all, for whatever reason, send us an email. info@weareinterconnected.com. I'll post it down below as well. And we'll definitely send it to you for free. But the ebook is very cheap. It's $4. It's a donation for the work that I've done, 5 years of research, writing, editing, etc., etc. And it's really a evolution and revolution that we're on. And we need to understand what is our purpose. And if we don't think that there is a purpose or there is a meaning to this existence, then we really need to understand who am I? Truly, who am I and why am I here? That's the two things that we need to understand. Who am I and why am I here on this planet? You know, you were born for a reason. People were born for a reason. And people will say, well, I was born just because my mom had sex with my dad. And in a way, that's true. But everyone is here on this planet for a reason. And of course, the more wealthy, the more well-off people like us in the Western world, we have a better chance to understand our purpose and a better chance to fulfill that purpose. And so just understand where you lie in this world, what your mission and your purpose is, and what the meaning of life is. And all the saints and all the sages and all the masters of this world said two things that the purpose of, and I have another video about this that I'll post down below, but basically the meaning of life or the purpose of this existence is nonviolence and unconditional love. And that means to all beings. So we don't harm, we don't use, we don't kill any other living being, sentient being. And so my journey is a slow, but, you know, slow journey. I mean, the first 26 years I was eating animals and animal products. And then I awakened. I didn't fully awaken, of course. I went vegan. But there's still a lot of healing, a lot of spiritual growth and evolution in my part. And a lot of healing. A lot of healing, a lot of studying, and a lot of learning, and a lot of things that I just ultimately need to do in order to raise my consciousness to a level that of Buddha, or even further than that. And so we need to get to deep veganism. We need to get beyond this stage of veganism, deep veganism, and even further to fruitarianism and beyond. And I'm trying to be 99%+ raw, even though I don't like to use the numbers of how raw are you, 99, 98, 90, 90%, whatever. You know, I don't like to say that because there are times when, you know, I do eat roasted seaweed, or I do eat, you know, cooked food on for emergency situations or whatever. You know, if I don't have food around, I have to eat something. And it's always going to be vegan, of course, always vegan whenever I can. But always, of course. But fruit is my number one priority, and try to get as much fruit as possible. And with the addition of some succulent vegetables and occasionally nuts and seeds, with, of course, B12 and in winter, vitamin D. And so my journey has really come a long way after these 32 plus years. In February, I will be 33, which is, you know, a great number. And every number is a great number, and I don't even like numbers. In fact, 33 means nothing to me because it just means that I've been living here for 33 years. And, you know, that's young. When I'm 43, when I'm 83, I'll still be young because it's all up here and it's all down here in the heart and in the mind. And so find out what your purpose is and the meaning of life is. Once you find out that, you can do what you like. I mean, be happy, be loving, caring. Of course, be vegan is number one. And strive to do even more than vegan. And with all your purchases and all your whatever, you know, just support as much as you can. Support vegan companies, support activists that are doing their part to make this world a better place. And if you can, if you have the money, please support the honest and caring people and organizations of this world. And do the best that you can. And the best that we can is not eating animals, not eating animal products, not using and killing animals, not destroying the environment, not wrecking our health, you know, and just do the best that we can. If you like these videos, please like, share, and subscribe. And please let me know what other videos you'd like me to create. I create these videos usually on the fly, so there's usually hardly ever any editing. And if there is any editing, very rarely. But I like to do it on the fly. I like to give you clean and honest information and thoughts for myself. So again, share these videos around with everyone. This is how I make my living. And also, don't forget to get my book, The Interconnectedness of Life. Share it around. Much love, everyone. Bye for now.